Do you guys remember Solar Freakin Roadways? They went viral back in 2014 with the promise of replacing traditional pavement roads with solar panels you could drive on. This sounds great, right? All of a sudden, every driving, walking, parking, or any other outdoor surface is covered in solar panels with warming capabilities and LED lights, all while sending electricity back to the grid. Why would we want plain old roads when we could have solar freakin' roadways? At the time, it looked like this solar road technology was in the nearest future, but yet 8 years have passed since that YouTube video got 22 million views, and yet solar roadways are still nowhere to be found. So what happened? Did big asphalt crush them under their rocky fists? Did the tech not work? Did big oil shut it down? Well, I'm gonna give you the answer to that today. My name is Kobe Hunter, and I love learning about business, finance, and entrepreneurship. I feel like there's so much we can learn from the successes and failures of the past. If you guys want cool business and personal finance videos, be sure to subscribe. I post a long form video like this one every week with shorts more regularly. Thank you guys again for subscribing. It really helps out the channel. And now let's get into why solar roadways failed. Reason number one, light and efficiency. On a traditional solar farm, solar panels are angled towards the sun to maximize efficiency. On even more advanced farms, the panels are actually made to rotate to track the sun, further improving the amount of energy they can extract. A typical solar panel can utilize about 15 to 22% of the energy that the sun produces. Optimizing the amount of light that the panels are exposed to is extremely important to run an efficient and effective system. On the other hand, solar roadways that lay flat minimize the panel's exposure to direct sunlight. Solar panels are most efficient when in direct sunlight, so laying a solar panel flat will result in 60% less power when compared to direct sunlight. So that 20% in an optimal situation from the sun becomes just 8% from lack of sunlight in a solar roadway. The panels are also likely to be covered by dirt and dust and would need far thicker glass than conventional panels to withstand the weight of traffic, which will further limit the light they can absorb. Let's say these factors reduce the panel's effectiveness by an optimistic 25%. So now we're at 6% absorbed from the sun. These panels are also going to have shade on them much more often than solar farms that are far away from trees and houses. We know that shade over just 5% of the surface of a solar panel can reduce the power generation by 50%. So our 6% from the sun just became 3% from the sun. On top of being only 15% as efficient as traditional solar panels, solar freaking roadways are fixed in place on the ground and are unable to benefit from air circulation like freestanding or roof-mounted panels can. If panels get too hot, their efficiency falls, and for most solar panels, every 1 degree Celsius over the ideal temperature, the panel loses about 0.5% efficiency. So in the absolute best case scenario with the current tech we have, you need almost 7 square feet of solar roadway to get the same amount of energy as 1 square foot of a traditional solar panel. This is a serious problem that is compounded by the next two factors. Reason number two, durability. The average lifespan of a solar panel is 25 years. This gives the solar panel plenty of time to pay off the high initial cost of building and installing the panels. Guess how long the couple of test cases of solar roadways have lasted? Seriously, pause the video right now and put it in the comments below. How long do you think a solar roadway's lifespan is? Well, in the three test case scenarios we have, the lifespan is between 5 days and 2 years. To be fair, the 5 days one was in China, and that damage was allegedly caused by a group of thieves who stole one of the 6 foot sections of the 0.6 mile road. But I think it should be included because since the panels are expensive, people stealing them should be part of the durability factor, right? The other test cases included a 150 square foot town square in Idaho. Remember, it's a town square, not a road. This test case broke almost immediately and also caught on fire at one point. After an upgrade, the panels have worked well, but only received light foot traffic. Our third durability test case was built in France. In December of 2016, France unveiled a 1 kilometer or 0.6 mile solar road made out of approximately 31,000 square feet of solar panels. This road was built by Wattway, a different company from Solar Roadways with slightly different technology, and it was the longest solar roadway in the world at the time. But only 2 years later in 2018, the solar road was already worse for wear, and 295 feet, or about a football field, had to be demolished. Unfortunately, as we mentioned before, shade from things like rotting leaves sitting on the road, cracks in the panels, and a lack of sun made solar roadways even less effective than the optimistic predictions of these companies. The most electricity the French example made in a year was 80,000 kilowatt hours, which is a lot less than the 150,000 kilowatt hours the company predicted. On top of the durability and efficiency problems, the road was not pleasant to drive on. Due to the road material and the way the panels were constructed, driving on this road was extremely loud. By 2019, Wattway threw in the towel and said the project was canceled. Reason number three, cost. We've already established that although solar roadways sound really cool, they are not anywhere as efficient as traditional solar panels. They have a shorter lifespan than panels, and they are not as comfortable to drive on as a normal road. All of these things could be forgiven to a degree if solar roadways were less expensive than their solar panel brothers or asphalt cousins. As you could probably guess, that is definitely not the case. For the demonstration project in Idaho, the panels had a capacity of 1.529 kilowatts with an installation cost of $48,734, which meant the cost per installed kilowatt is about $33,000. This is about 20 times higher than the per kilowatt price at a solar farm. Remember that 0.6 mile long test road in France? Yeah, it cost $5.2 million to build. For perspective, to build the same amount of road with asphalt, it would cost between $300,000 and $600,000, or about a tenth of the cost. Now you might be saying, yeah, it'll be more expensive now, but won't it pay for itself in the long run? Well, no, not really. If you want the solar freaking roadway like the video advertised, that means that you want LED lighting in the panels for the lane markers and heated panels to melt the snow and ice off them. These two features seriously eat into the energy generation of the panels. Solar Roadways estimates that for one lane of a mile-long road, the panels would generate 415 megawatt hours of energy, with 106 megawatt hours going to the lights. So comparing back to our original numbers, we are now only taking 2.55% of the energy from the sun. And then if you want heating in the panels, you'll only have enough energy to heat the panel for 6 days before it will consume more energy than it produces in a year. So heating is pretty much out of the question. Now to be clear, I'm not hating on solar. I'm a big fan of renewable energy. I think it's super cool that we can take energy from the sun and harness it, but solar roadways are just too expensive, fragile, and inefficient. For perspective on how costly and inefficient the roads are, the French road could power about 401 homes a day for its $5 million price tag, which is pretty cool. But when you compare it to a local solar power plant that has panels that rotate to face the sun, that plant can power 30,000 homes for a tenth of the price per home as the roadway can. That's the crux of it. Solar roadways are just not good enough in any of the three characteristics of price, durability, or efficiency. And thus, the present and future rely on many effective alternatives to this technology. Alternatives. The problem with solar roadways is not just that they are expensive, fragile, and inefficient. Most new technology starts out that way. The problem is that they are all those things while there are many less expensive, more efficient, and more durable alternatives. A lot of these are not nearly as sexy as solar roadways, but some are actually kind of cool. Obviously, instead of solar roadways, we could just have giant solar farms. This solution, although very efficient, has negative side effects like taking up lots of land, creating extreme heat islands, and relying on energy companies to invest in them when things like coal and gas are much cheaper. Plus, it's just not as sexy as solar roadways. Another solution people have been buying instead of solar roadways is solar panels on the roofs of buildings. The tops of buildings are already not being used for anything important, so it doesn't have the problem of taking up lots of land like a traditional solar farm does. Also, because they are using the tops of buildings, they have less shade on them. Also, one of the selling points of solar roadways is that there is 60,000 miles of roads that could create solar energy, but the amount of available rooftops puts this number to shame. It's estimated that only covering 50% of the buildings' roofs in the United States with solar panels would cover all the United States' energy needs. Now, we are a ways off from that right now. As of 2022, only about 4% of buildings in the United States have solar. But the great news is that CBS reported that the American solar usage is set to triple by 2023, which will be great for the environment and everyone's wallets. And thus we see why solar roadways haven't taken off. Why invest in an inefficient technology that doesn't work well when there's such a big market available for normal solar panels that has not yet been fully utilized? Besides boring old solar panels on roofs, here's an alternative that's a little sexier. Places like California or Nevada or Arizona already have much more solar roofing than states like Wisconsin or New York, just because the amount of sun in these warm, sunny places makes solar panels an attractive financial option. Some schools and companies in these warm weather states have already maxed out their solar roof potential, but rather than purchasing solar roadways, they instead install solar panel covers over parking lots. This makes even more land available to solar development while also keeping people's cars cool from the hot sun. And again, they are much less expensive, more efficient, and more durable than solar roadways. It makes sense why no one has seriously gotten behind the idea of solar roadways. There are just too many other compelling options that are competing for people's dollars. Now, could solar roadways become a thing in the future? Maybe, but I think the days of our roads being covered are decades, if not centuries, in the future. The reality is we have so far to go applying simpler solar concepts before solar roadways will even become economically feasible. We've only got 4% of the buildings in the United States covered with solar panels. That's crazy. We know that this tech works, we just have to keep applying it. And if I had the choice of installing $1 billion of solar paneled roofs and powering 1 million homes, or installing $1 billion of solar roadways and powering 100,000 homes, I'm picking the boring old solar panels every time. But what do you think? Do you think solar freaking roadways will make a comeback? How many years do you think it'll take for us to get to 25% or even 50% of the buildings in the United States covered with solar panels? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. I really want to hear what you have to say. You guys, I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. I hope you found it interesting and informative. If you did, be sure to give this video a like. And since you're still here right now, you probably like videos like this one, so be sure to subscribe as well. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thanks again, and remember, you're awesome. I'll see you next time.